Hello guys, so in this video, I'll show you some tips and tricks which you can use on a Lenovo phone for that matter. Particularly, I am using Lenovo A6000 in this video, but almost all the tips and tricks can be used on any Lenovo phone. So let's get started. First of all, I had an issue of several crashes, like the phone was hanging a lot. And when I used to press this, when I used to come in multitasking mode, it was not able to clear the RAM and the phone was hanging a lot. Like even if I scroll like this, then the phone was hanging. So to fix that, what I did is simply switch off your phone. And when the phone is switched off, simply hold both the volume keys and the power button together. And when the phone vibrates, just leave the buttons. And as you can see over here, you will come into Android recovery. Now scroll down and come to the fourth option, which says wipe cache partition, and hit power button to select. And now it will wipe cache, as you can see over here, formatting cache. After the cache wipe is complete, come to reboot system now and simply hit power button once again. Now we'll reboot into the phone once again. And this is how I fixed all the crashes which were occurring on the phone. And by doing this, that surely helped me a lot, because earlier the phone was hanging, the lagging issue was there. But after I followed this method, the phone was not hanging and lagging at all. So that's really nice thing. And I don't know why we have to do it manually, because the phone should not hang actually. Yeah, that's why. And next trick is that, as you can see over here, there is network speed shown. So if you want this type of network speed too, then simply go to security. This is the Lenovo's application. And now go to settings over here on the right side. And now if I select data bar, then as you can see, there is network speed shown over here, and it shows network speed in real time. So that's a really nice thing for the phone. And if you want this to be a fixed data bar window, like if you want this to be here only, then you can select fixed data bar window and it will be fixed. Now you cannot move. But if you want to move further, then simply disable this option and you can move wherever you want. I prefer to have it over here, so I put it over here and select fixed data bar window. So this is how you can set the network speed. And you can have a look at the network speed always. And now another thing which is very important for data pack users is that many times, even after the data consumption, like if you have 1 GB of limit, even after we cross that, we do not realize that. So if you are using Lenovo phone, then you can simply set that. Like if we set monthly data limit, as it's saying no SIM card is available, if we go over here, then you can simply select the monthly data limit of 1 GB or 100 MB or 200 MB and simply set that. And whenever we are about to reach the limit, it will tell us that we are about to reach the limit, so that we can come to know and we can reduce our data usage. So that's a really nice thing. And another trick is that if you like to check battery percentage, what is consuming the battery all the time, then for that you have to go in settings, then go into battery, and then you have to come over here. But we have another option. Simply long press on the home screen. Now swipe to settings. Select these settings over here. Select that. And after that, you will come to these many menus. So if you want to select battery, then simply select battery. And as you can see, if we click over here, then we'll directly come into battery. And that's really nice thing. And by using this, you can set dual SIM priority too, because many times we want only one SIM to be active and another SIM to be not active. Then we can easily do that. Then once again, follow the same steps, select settings, and now select dual SIM settings. As you can see, dual SIM settings is over here. Simply select that, and it is saying dual SIM settings already exists. So that's over here. Let's see how that performs. If we select that, then you can select which SIM to be active right now. And if you want only one SIM to be active, then you can simply select that from over here. And that's a really nice thing. And one more important thing, and this is one of the best way, is that if we long press the power button and if we click power off, you will see something as fast boot up. And what this means is that when we normally switch off the phone, all the complete phone is switched off, nothing is running, and all the cores, processor, RAM and everything is completely switched off. But when we select fast boot up, the phone is not completely switched off, everything is running at very low voltage, that's completely negligible. Because of this, less time is required to boot up the phone. I'll show you right now. If we select fast boot up and hit OK, then the phone will shut down. And as you can see, the phone is shutting down. And now I'll press the power button to switch on the phone and see how fast the phone boots up. And as you can see, the phone booted up too. So this is how you can use fast boot up. And that's really useful thing when sometimes you only want to switch off the phone for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. So yeah, this is very good thing. And another important thing is that many people like to use launchers on this phone. And now if you want to switch between the launchers, like if you have 4 to 5 launchers installed and if you want to switch between them on the go, then simply go into settings, then select home over here. And now select whichever launcher you want. Like if I select Nova launcher or Lenovo launcher, select Nova launcher, hit home button, and Nova launcher will be there. As you can see, this is the Nova launcher. But if you want the Lenovo launcher only, then simply go into settings, go into home, and select Lenovo launcher. And that's it. You have to do only these steps. Otherwise, in stock Android, you have to go into settings, then go into Nova launcher application, then clear the defaults of the Nova launcher application, and that's quite frustrating sometimes. So that's why this is very, very useful. And now another easy trick is that if you want to edit these apps over here, then simply long press over here and a widget window will come over here. The apps beside this, we want to edit that. So for that, simply hit over here. And now you can edit these options too, like select Chrome and remove this. And if I want music player to be here, then I can select that. If I want Chrome to be here in this messaging folder, then I can do that too. And now a folder will be created. And now if you want to rename this folder, then simply click over here and name it whatever you want. I'll name it my name only. I don't know why I named it my name, but yeah, that's okay. So you can do that too. So yeah, one more easy trick is that if you just scroll from here on the right side or from here, then you can simply change the wallpapers. Like if I scroll from here on the right top edge of the phone, then we can switch between the wallpapers on the go. And that's very convenient and very easy to use. To set this up, simply go into options on the home screen, then go into desktop setting and select swipe to change wallpapers. When you select this option, you can do that. So yeah, that's very, very easy and very useful options. As you can see, if I don't like this wallpaper, then I can simply change this by swiping from the right or left. And one more important thing is that if we go into options once again from here, you can manage the screens from here. Like if you want this screen to be your home screen, whenever you press home button, you want the phone to come on this screen, then you can simply do that. And whenever you press home button, the phone will come on this screen and not on this screen. So that's really useful sometimes, because many people like to have one home screen, then two home screens on this side and two home screens on this side. So you can set that up like that too. And if you want to add any screens, then simply go into screen manager once again and you can add as many as you want. So yeah, so this is how you can add. And if you simply want to close any of these, then simply hit on the cross over here. And if you want to move this screen, then long press on them and select this. And now if we select this as our home screen, then as you can see, we have one screen over here and three screens over here too. So that's really nice thing. One more option is that if we go into theme, then we can select different themes too. Like if I want this theme will look like this. You can simply select apply and the theme will be applied. So that's really nice thing. And now once again, I'll show you the switching between wallpapers. Yeah, there it is. As you can see, it's easily done and very, very easy to use and very handy option. This is pretty much it, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video, and don't forget to share this video with your friends who is having Lenovo phone. This might be very useful for them. So thank you guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. That helps me a lot. So thank you guys.